Fargo North High School had almost 300 students call out of class today after a threat of a school shooting was discovered yesterday afternoon. We were the first to tell you last night how Fargo North teachers found the threat written on a desk. It said, "I want to run away, school shooting," and the date 9/4/19. Officials say they investigated the threat but found it to not be credible. However, Fargo police had an extra presence on campus today as a precaution. Valley News Team's crime and safety reporter Bailey Hurley talked with Fargo Public Schools today, who say they're proud of how Fargo North handled the situation.
Even as the time creeped closer to first period, Fargo North's parking lot stayed bare. And that's because officials say out of around 900 students, 296 called out of class today, all stemming from yesterday's school shooting scare.
To determine that there isn't a threat, but yet parents and students still choose not to come to school, I completely understand that feeling, but it also puts school officials in a difficult situation. You know, we don't want this to become an opportunity for threats to be used as an excuse for not to be at school, because that could desensitize that, and it could also just create a culture we don't want.
Gandhi says after discovering the writings, Fargo Public Schools used their threat screener and worked with Fargo police, later determining there was, quote, no legitimacy to that threat being carried out.
Is there a plan, or are there access to anything that could carry out this threat? What was the context in which the threat was made? Because sometimes some things could just be stated, or in this case written, and they're meant to be a joke or they're not serious. So all of those things play into a factor of determining whether a threat is truly credible or not.
And because the threat was found improbable, FPS says there were no extra precautions taken at any schools nearby. And Gandhi says while there's always a concern for copycats, nothing led FPS to believe that would be a problem today.
I worry about any threat to our students, honestly, whether it's a natural disaster or whether it's a self-inflicted threat. That's just kind of the nature of our job, knowing that we have so many students that we serve on a day-to-day basis.
FPS says they will not be identifying the student responsible or what consequences they could be facing. In North Fargo, Bailey Hurley, Valley News Live.
We reached out to both West Fargo and Moorhead schools for a comment on how this scare affected their students, but have not heard back.